Namaskar, myself Pratik. In this session, we are going to discuss implementation of decision tree classifier. We are going to discuss need of feature scaling in this session. Let us start this session. In previous session, we have discussed that we are building a classifier to identify that whether the customer is going to purchase Alexa or not based on his input attributes like user ID, gender, age, and minutes of music consumed. We are only considering age and minutes of music as input attribute while purchased as output attribute. In last session, we have loaded the data set and created our X and Y, and then we have performed train test supply. In this session, we are going to discuss the importance of feature scaling. If you observe closely about our independent variables in X, you can see that in first column, we have age and whose values is in it 2-digit number. While in second column, we have minutes of music consumed and its value is in 5- and 6-digit number. If you closely observe about the range of these values, we found that the age is in the range of 18 to 60 years, while the values of minutes of music consumed is in the range of 15,000 to 1,50,000 minutes. So you can clearly see that both the input attributes are at different scale. While for age, we have values in the 2-digit number, while for next column, we have values in 5- and 6-digit number. So when we built our model on this data set, of course, the column which has values in the higher range will get more biased as compared to a column which has very small values. We can understand that the values of first column are very small as compared to values in the second column. Since machine learning models are based on statistical data, the second column will get more biased as compared to first column because its values are in higher range as compared to the values of first column, that is age. So it is very important to have all the values in the same range before building the model. You can further understand the importance of feature scaling by considering the values of our blood test results. There are some fields whose values are in just points, while there are some other columns where the values are in thousands. The small variation in points is very important in case of one column, while the small variation in points are not important for another columns because its range is in thousands or maybe in hundreds. So it is very important to feature scale all the columns at the same range before building the machine learning model. Same way, in this case, we have age and minutes of music consumed. One column has the values in thousands and lakhs, while another column is just have a values less than 100. So of course, the second column, which has the values in the range of lakhs, will get more important as compared to the column which has the values just below 100. In order to remove the biasing, we should feature scale all the columns in the same range. So that's why in most of the cases, feature scaling is very important step of pre-processing. So in this case, we have to apply feature scaling to keep this data set in the same range. And in order to apply feature scaling, we have two techniques. One is normalization and another is standardization. We will discuss the details of these techniques in next video session. This is all about this session. I request all of you to subscribe this YouTube channel to receive latest video tutorials on topics like machine learning, data mining, DBMS, big data, NoSQL, and many more. To learn DBMS in a simplified way, you can join this online course on DBMS, which is available at Udemy platform. We have also created online course on SQL and PLSQL, and all these courses are also available on Udemy platform. I have also authored books on data mining and data warehousing, DBMS, NoSQL, Beginning with SQL, and PLSQL for Beginners. All these books are available at Amazon platform. To read more about this, you can refer my website pratikbhatia.com. Thanks for watching this video.